10, Michigan State Spartans return home to Jennison Fieldhouse to take on the number 25 Illinois Fighting Illini to honor National Women and Girls in Sports Day here on Big Ten Plus. Hello, everyone. I'm Maren Klein. Alongside me, Michigan State gymnast alumni Sarah Sageman. And to honor National Women and Girls in Sports Day here on Big Ten Plus, we have an all-female crew for this broadcast. Very exciting. But now, looking back down to the floor, both these teams ranked in the top 25, Michigan State jumping up from 14 to 10 after that historic win against Michigan.
Yes, the Spartans were able to go on the road last weekend at U of M and earned that coveted 198 score, which is so hard to come by in collegiate gymnastics. They're looking to keep that momentum rolling for tonight.
Very big win for Michigan State, and Illinois having a big win of their own against Rutgers, that conference matchup. And a huge key to that win for the Fighting Illini was all-around gymnast Abby Mueller.
Abby competed really well last weekend. She was able to get a 39 in the all-around, which was first place for that meet. She also got a 9.95, which is a personal best for her on floor 2 weekends prior against Nebraska.
And speaking of best, looking to Michigan State, the Big Ten Specialist of the Week, Sage Kellerman, earned her second perfect 10 on the vault in that weekend against Michigan.
She did, and she is the epitome of what an anchor position means in collegiate gymnastics. She's been consistent through the season. She's really looking to keep building on those two solid 10 scores that she's gotten, obviously, which are an amazing feat for her to have accomplished.
A lot of excitement here for this meet, but before we get started, we're going to send it down to the third and fourth members of our team, Lexi Alston and Nora Fleming, who have a little more on another MSU gymnast that made some Big Ten headlines this week.
Thanks, Maren. Michigan State Gymnastics is celebrating National Girls and Women in Sports Day today at Jennison.
And to continue to acknowledge the accomplishments of women in sports, the Michigan State field hockey and volleyball team are here hosting a meet and greet for the local community and a few special kiddos.
That's right. MSU gymnasts will be walking in with local young gymnasts, as well as having young gymnasts announce the MSU starting lineup over the PA and serve as score runners at today's meet.
There's so much to celebrate, so don't go anywhere. Women's gymnastics is up next on Big Ten Plus.
Hello and welcome into Jennison Fieldhouse as we get ready to start this meet off between Michigan State and Illinois. Michigan State will be starting on the vault first with the Fighting Illini on the bars for this first rotation. Take a look at the Fighting Illini competition order. Abby Mueller, Destiny Denning, Amelia Knight, Caitlin Ewald, Mia Takakawa, and Lyden Saltness for Illinois on the bars. Get a look at Illinois' head coach, Natalie Walsh, in her seventh season. A good record with this team. Looking to get some more conference wins tonight after that win against Rutgers. Now looking over to Michigan State on the vault, their competition order, Skyla Schulte, Tara Walsh, Michaela Tucker, Gabby Steven, Nikki Smith, and Sage Kellerman at that anchor spot. As we take a look at head coach Mike Rowe, also his seventh season with Michigan State, past few years has had big success with this team, the Big Ten regular season champions in 2023. As we get ready here, both teams warming up. Illinois struggled a little bit on bars in their meet against Rutgers, but Mia Takakawa for Rutgers had a 9.9, a great score for her to win the event for the Fighting Illini against Rutgers.
Yes, that was a clutch position to get a 9.9 to up the ante on the team total for that bars rotation for them.
Michigan State on vault, like we mentioned, Sage Kellerman with that perfect 10, but Michigan State up and down on the vault, some really consistent scores against the University of Michigan. Nikki Smith, very close that perfect 10, had a 9.95.
She did. It was a great vault she performed at University of Michigan. Hopefully she can recreate that tonight.
Both teams about a little under 2 minutes left in their warm-ups. They're getting underway here. Both teams are going to have some exhibitions as well on the bars. Ariel Ward for Illinois and Ortiz and Sawyer on vault for exhibitions for Michigan State.
And
collegiate gymnastics, the athletes are given a four-minute touch just before their event begins. They have warmed up everything prior in the day, but are given just this last minute to do one extra routine.
We get a look here at Sage Kellerman's perfect 10 at Michigan. A beautiful vault for her to get that second. The first Spartan to get two perfect 10s on the same event. We see Kellerman here. Preparing, like you said, Sarah, in our open. A great anchor spot for Michigan State. A really strong gymnast as we see her there, and almost a perfect vault just on her practice run.
Recreate that when it's time to go.
The clock winding down. Getting underway here. Gabby Ortiz, the freshman, getting her warm-up in. She went down on that warm-up. We'll have Skyla Schulte up first for Michigan State. And Abby Mueller up on the bars. First for the Fighting Illini. As time expires, and we are ready to get this meet started in honor of National Women and Girls in Sports Day, both these teams honoring that, as well as Black History Month here for the whole month of February. Spartan fans crowding into Jenison on this Friday night in East Lansing. Teams getting in their final before starting in on this first rotation.
Skyla Schulte will begin for the Spartans, and she starts with a Yurchenko full vault. In collegiate gymnastics, you are trying to earn a 10 as your start value on every rotation. In vault, they downgraded the Yurchenko full to a 9.95, which is what Skyla will start with.
Skyla had a 9.85 against the University of Michigan, tying her season high.
Nice execution in the vault. Just a slight scoop back for her of the feet, about a half tenth deduction or so. Very nice way to start the meet for Michigan State.
Yeah, beautiful vault there. For Skyla Schulte, get another look at that.
It's a nice open shoulder angle as she comes into the table. Good block off the table as well. And just that small scoop, she saved a bigger deduction by a larger hop. That was a great save there.
And now here on the bars, Abby Mueller, starting off her routine.
She has a Jaeger release move. Just shy on a handstand there. On bars, we're really looking for a handstand just like that one to be right on top of the rail. They should be vertically. They have a 10-degree leeway before deduction incurs on a handstand. Gearing up for her dismount here, a double layout. It was close to a stick, maybe a slight shuffle of that left foot, but nice way to start the meet off for Illinois as well.
Yeah, really strong ways for both teams to start, like you said. Small shuffle there, looked like feet weren't entirely together on that landing. But really strong starting performances from both these squads. We get a look at Tara Walsh getting ready for her vault, scoring 9.8 against Michigan last weekend.
For the judges to finish calculating the score for Skyla.
Mm-hmm.
You're also doing that Yurchenko full. Slight pike down of the hips as she's finishing the rotation there. Had to take the hop backwards to compensate for that pike in the angle of her hips.
And Skyla Schulte, her score coming in at a 9.875 as we get another look at Walsh's.
Angle down there, she can squeeze a little more and maybe eliminate that hop.
So Skyla Schulte, a new season best on the vault to start things off for Michigan State. And now Destiny Denning for Illinois getting ready for her bar routine. Denning had a 9.875 against Rutgers last weekend.
Toe circle to a major release to the high bar and back down, overshoot hand to the low bar. You're required to do a major release skill in collegiate gymnastics. She's building up here for her dismount. Nice toe point she has in those giants. And I think she got the stick. Get a slight pike down that into that double layout. We'll see if the judges take execution for that pike down or not, but good second routine for the Illinois.
Yeah, I get another look at that dismount from Denning.
Just a scoot her feet under herself. Oh, maybe a slight shuffle of that left foot again. Nice routine, though.
Now Michaela Tucker up for Michigan State had a season high 9.925 at the University of Michigan, Big Ten Freshman of the Week.
Kayla does do the 1.5 vault as opposed to just the full that we saw from the first two competitors. She took a sizable step forward. Stepping forward, though, shows that you have over-rotation versus under-rotation, so that's a positive thing to have. She had too much power today. Nice execution in the air, though, as you can see in the replay here.
Now Amelia Knight. Getting ready for her bar routine, the third Fighting Illini for this first rotation. Had a 9.875 versus Rutgers. As that first score from Mueller came in at a 9.825. So we get the salute from Knight to start her routine.
Starts in the same manner, that pit between the rails here. Toe circle to major release, back down to the overshoot. That's a pretty common routine sequence there, series sequence to have on uneven bars at the moment. A little bit shy on that cast to handstand. She can get the stick on the dismount here. Nice execution in that double layout. Beautiful job.
A really nice stick there for Amelia Knight, and the team is loving it, and the fans coming from Illinois as we get another look.
Nice stretched extension in her hips on that double layout. Stayed open the whole way down to the floor.
A strong routine from Knight, and now over to Gabby Steven for Michigan State on the vault. She had a 9.85 last weekend in Ann Arbor.
Gabby is capable of doing a 1.5. Michigan State is trying to determine which score is better for her, that 1.5 or the nice open body full like she just did. Didn't quite get the stick today. She's able to do that, been able to do so in the past. We'll see what the judges give her for that score today. Gabby competed her 1.5 in the first couple of meets of the season. It was scoring in the 9.8 range, though. I think they're trying to hope for that Yurchenko full instead to get the stick, get a little bit higher on her score total.
Caitlin Ewald getting ready for her routine for Illinois. Amelia Knight, previous for Illinois, just got the 9.85 for her routine.
It's a nice way to keep building scores here as Illinois moves forward. A little bit close shoulder angle. She really had this hold on to her fingertips to keep that catch. Nice recovery there to the back salto to the low bar. Back up here, gearing up for her dismount. And she does a tuck full in. Small step on the dismount. Illinois has been pretty consistent across those bar routines, four down.
Take another look at that dismount.
A little bit of leg separation as she lifts into the initial tuck body position. Sometimes that angle is hard to see from the judges with leg separation from the side.
Now Nikki Smith gearing up for her bar routine. Vault.
Her vault here is a 1.5. Almost got the stick. She nailed that one last weekend, had a slight step forward today. Again, a little bit of a step forward is better than a step behind yourself. That shows you had extra power versus an under rotation. That's something the judges can take execution for, an under being under rotated. Nice block off the table though, she opens. Just pulled her head forward a slight bit, had to take that small step forward.
Nice look, Smith. Had the 9.95, a season high at Michigan. Might not be scoring that on that one, but still a good vault as Mia Takakawa had the team high 9.9 versus Rutgers.
Mia uses a springboard to mount the apparatus. That is okay to do. They just have teammates on the side that'll get that board out of the way as soon as she's up and on the bar. Nice pirouette into her release. Little bit of form on that release here. Nice handstand though on the low bar after her overshoot. She has nailed the dismount. Beautiful finish to that double layout dismount for Nia.
Beautiful stick there for Takakawa. You like to see from a really consistent gymnast on the bars for this team. Take another look. And now for Michigan State, Sage Kellerman. We saw it in practice, her sticking the landing on that vault. She'll be looking to do it again for real this time.
She enters the vault forward versus backwards like we've seen so far. And another stick for Sage. She is rock solid in this anchor position for Michigan State.
Sage Kellerman, such a solid gymnast and a reason she scored those two perfect tens on this vault.
So in this replay, you can see she runs forward and enters the table right off the springboard. The other competitors prior to herself did a round off onto the board and entered the table reaching backwards toward it.
Now Lyden Saltness, the final gymnast for Illinois in this routine. Then they'll have one exhibition, Michigan State still with two gymnasts for an exhibition on vault.
Lyden's mounting on the high bar. Nice handstand to begin the routine. Good, a little bit close on that catch, slight bent elbows. Nice recovery though to get the handstand afterwards. Beautiful toe point she has as she's swinging bars here. She's making it look nice and smooth and effortless. Full pirouette into her double tuck dismount and got the stick. Beautiful finish for the Illini.
Really solid on the bars for Illinois, and a great way to finish it out from Lyden Saltness. Be looking to score big on that one. And now Gabby Ortiz gearing up for her exhibition vault.
Gabby doing her chinko 1.5. A little bit of leg execution while she's twisting in the air. And a hop forward, and she went a little bit to the left, close to that white line on the outer edge. That is a newer addition to college gymnastics. You see these white lines that are on the mat here. So she jumps a little bit left and toward that mat. That just shows she was still rotating as her feet were touching the ground. So judges can take execution for that, meaning that she was not in control of her landing as she was finishing her vault. The format for college gymnastics is 6 girls compete, 5 scores count. So if you have a mistake in one of the routines, you can get rid of that score. Obviously, you're trying to count the 5 best scores out of that 6 total.
Here's Ariel Ward on her exhibition routine for Illinois.
Very nice amplitude on that release move she just did. Overshoot down to the low bar here. Good solid cast to handstand. And a full end dismount. Small step behind herself. That's a beautiful exhibition routine, though, they could add in the lineup if they ever needed so. Sometimes it's nice to have exhibitions that can slide in there to rest a gymnast or have that score that you won't drop your team total from using.
Always nice to have that depth in your team, knowing your exhibitions can still score if a gymnast needs a break. And now Katie Sawyer for her exhibition vault. Final to go for the Spartans in this rotation.
Katie is doing your Chinko full. Again, a slight pike down. Didn't quite see the height on Katie's Yurchenko full that we had seen some of the other gymnasts that were in the lineup. But again, a nice exhibition routine. So it doesn't quite get the pop off the table. So she's not as high as she's finishing that full. Also has to pike down a little bit to save that landing some for herself.
And here's Allie Morgan. Also on an exhibition for Illinois.
Mounting the high bar here. Not quite a full handstand on that initial cast. Reverse hex, nice amplitude there though. A little bit of body positioning as she was doing her squat on the low bar. And full pirouette into double tuck. Released a little bit early in the double tuck. Didn't, again, quite give her the height that we had seen from some of the other dismounts through the Illini rotation. But again, nice to get in front of the judges, nice to get some scores, get some more numbers under their belts for those exhibition routines.
And that will finish up this first rotation here for both of these teams. Both really strong performances. Now we're going to send it down to Lexi Alston with Illinois head coach. Welcome back into Jennison Fieldhouse. Michigan State leading after that first rotation, 49.35 to 49.225. So a very close meet after that first rotation. Really good performances from both these sides. We see Illinois' competition order that bar those results. Mueller with a 9.825. Denning, 9.75. Knight, 9.85. Ewald, 9.8. Takakawa had hers, and now we're going to go right over to their competition order for the vault. Burn, Fitzgibbon, Takakawa, Mueller, Coppola, and Ward to finish it up. Now looking over to Michigan State. Over seeing their vault scores here. See Sage Kellerman down below the 9.925, so not a perfect 10, but still a really good score.
Solid job for the Spartans. It wasn't quite the team total they were able to receive last weekend at their meet against the University of Michigan, but a solid beginning to the meet here. They can build upon that.
Now Michigan State's competition order, Stephen Schulte, Zamari, Kellerman, Smith, and Harkness anchoring for the bars for this second rotation. A lot to like here from Michigan State on the bars. Both these teams strong in these. Illinois struggled just a little bit versus Rutgers on the vault. Not as high scores they wanted to. We'll be looking to turn that around today. Both teams setting up about a minute 30 left before getting this second rotation underway.
New to college gymnastics this year on the landings, being whether or not they move their feet and have a stick or a step is easy to see. But what's new this season is that when they stick a landing, when they land, they must have at least 1 second pause before they turn to salute the judges. It used to be what was deemed the old college stick, where they would feet would hit, and as soon as their feet touched, they would turn and salute the judges. It got to be a little bit subjective in terms of whether they were actually giving that stick value or taking a deduction for that. So they have made a new rule. You must hold for 1 second prior to turning to salute.
Winding down here, getting ready to start this second rotation. And time winding down. So Aaliyah Byrne will start off on the vault for Illinois, and Gabby Steven on the bars first for Michigan State. Now time to start off the second rotation.
Vault always begins first and then bars follow. So this rotation, Illinois will begin. Michigan State will follow after that.
Did not compete on vault against Rutgers, but did the weekend before at Ohio State, had a 9.625. We'll be looking to score a little bit higher on today's vault here in East Lansing.
Slight pause here as the judges are getting ready.
Get the salute from Byrne to get the second rotation underway.
And your Chingo entry to a nice vault. Oh, save it. Slight hop back. She tried to keep her feet still. Had a little bit too much momentum and had to take a couple of extra steps. Unfortunately, that'll be a sizable deduction in terms of amount the judges can take for that landing for her. Yeah, nice execution, though, in the air.
Not exactly the landing that Byrne was looking for on that one. And now Gabby Stevens starting off her bar routine for Michigan State.
Nice major release to the high bar. Beautiful handstand on that overshoot for Gabby. She's working up the high bar to her dismount. Gaining some speed for her full in. Chest was forward on the landing. Didn't quite get the stick. Had to take that step forward due to her chest not being over her feet positioning wise as she landed. So here, just didn't quite finish the rotation fully. Had to take that small step. Nice routine though to begin.
Now Caden Fitzgibbon.
Looks like she might be chewing some gum before she begins her vault here.
Looks like order got switched and Ritu Nataraj will be going in that second place spot for the Fighting Illini.
And they get a nice Yurchenko full. Pike in the hips. They can get a little more amplitude off the table. They could eliminate that pike down. And then also find the landing a little more easily. You have more time in the air to be able to see where the ground is coming. But solid vaults here for Illinois to start the rotation.
Now Skyla Schulte getting ready for her bar routine for Michigan State.
Major release to the high bar. She's had a little bit of trouble on that through the season. She's not competed in every weekend here on even bars, so looking good thus far on this routine. She has a lot of power in her giants as she comes around. Oh, good fight for the landing there to get the stick. Nice routine from Skyla. She has such a stretched position in that double layout that we'll show again here. Nice lift, and she stays flat across the front of the hips the whole way through the skill. Had to get a slight arm swing on that landing. Judges can take a deduction for the lack of control as she was finishing.
And like you said, Schulte not going every weekend, didn't perform on uneven bars just last week against University of Michigan, but had a 9-9 the weekend before against Iowa.
Back to Illinois on the vault here. And Yurchenko full. A little more power coming off the table here. Small step back.
Push from Caden Fitzgibbon.
Her hands were at the very back of the table. She'd benefit a little more from being toward the center. More so, it'll help you get the most amplitude coming off of the table afterwards.
Olivia Zarmani for Michigan State hasn't been seen in every meet set out for Penn State and Iowa meets. Came back. Michigan had a 9.85 on uneven bars.
Olivia has some of the most difficulty in her bar routine of the rest of the lineup that we'll see tonight. She actually has three release moves. She's done one thus far. That's the second up to the high bar and one in bar release here, a ginger. Beautiful job with that. Nice finish on that handstand. Just a small step backwards with her right foot on that dismount. Great routine there for Olivia.
And Jennison erupts in applause. Teammates all going to cheer her on. Is that a more difficult routine than some of her other teammates? And a great landing to finish it off for Olivia Zarmani.
Just a slight scooch of that right foot. Back to vault here, Yurchenko full. Had the nicest body position in that full. Got a little bit soft in the knees as she landed. Maybe wasn't quite ready for the floor to come. Had to take a small step backwards. But beautiful positioning in the air on this one. Nice toe point throughout. Just wasn't quite ready. Legs gave out a little bit for her on the finish there.
Now for Michigan State, Sage Kellerman tied her season high of a 9-9 on the uneven bars at Michigan.
Sage gets the go-ahead from the judges here. She begins with her major release right off the bat. And back down to the low bar. Nice position in the handstand there to finish that overshoot. Michigan State hitting all these handstands, which is critical to get big scores. Oh, and a slight step again with that left foot. We can't quite find the landings tonight. Nice routine overall, though, for Sage.
Really good routine for Michigan State and all around, just those landings.
The landings add up for sure. I don't think she actually needed this step. Let's see. Oh, barely. Second-guessed herself just a bit right toward the end there.
Abby Mueller on her vault for Illinois.
Abby had nice block off the table. So she had good air positioning. Took a step backwards and then had an extra step at the end. I'm not quite sure if her foot got stuck or shuffled. What happened here? Let's see if we can figure it out in the replay. So nice block there. Good positioning. Again, Pike down a bit and had that extra step. We'll see if the judges take that or not. She was trying to salute to finish it up.
Looks like both teams struggling a little bit on the landings here in the second rotation. And now Nikki Smith up for Michigan State on the bars. Right now the leading gymnast on the bars for Michigan State is Skyla Schulte with a 9.85.
Nice handstand to be in for Nikki here. Peck Salto down on the low bar after a major release. Oh, and had to do a full pirouette, didn't quite. She figured it out. So that was actually a pretty major mistake. Nikki was supposed to do a half pirouette on the low bar. Had to end up turning it into a full pirouette. But it could... Good save. So she did extra skills there, actually. She had to recast and do her half pirouette to then continue the routine as planned. This was the first one. She had to keep turning because she was finishing in between the bars. Didn't quite have that handstand in the right spot. But good to keep moving forward. Finish on that dismount. The judges will take some execution for sure for some leg separation and things on that full pirouette. But she did a great job trying to work through the routine still and not have a fall. Likely that will be the score that Michigan State wants to drop. We'll see what the judges give for her on that one.
Ward now getting ready for Illinois, highest score coming in for the Illini. On the vault so far, Fitzgibbon with a 9.775.
And nice, Yurchenko, 1.5. Oh, she had good amplitude off the table. Opened a little bit early on that skill. I think she was trying to go for the stick a little too soon. So that is an example of the under rotation that I had mentioned earlier. Her weight was still behind herself as she was finishing the skill. Couldn't quite hold it. Just didn't get enough forward momentum for herself finishing that 1.5.
Now moving back over to bars, Delaney Harkness for Michigan State.
Delaney's anchoring here. It's a nice ginger. Close on that handstand. Nice overshoot, though, that finish right on top of the bar. Nice finishing handstand as well. Hopefully she can get the stick here and finish out this anchor spot with a stick. She did. Great job.
Beautiful way to finish out for Michigan State. For the sixth gymnast there on the uneven bars. Taking another look at that dismount.
And got the stick. So as she landed, her feet were apart, but as long as the gymnasts can close their heels together as they salute, there's no deduction for that foot separation.
That might be the score that Michigan State's looking for in the uneven bars, not scoring as high as they might have liked.
Michigan State does have a couple of exhibition gymnasts. Illinois has finished the rotation on vault. It's nice to see the 1.5 done by the Fighting Illini. Having those 10-0 start values, especially as the season gets further progressed, it's nice to have the higher start value to try to compete with the bigger meets that are coming down the line for these teams.
Michaela Tucker for her exhibition against Iowa had a 9.775.
Nice casting handstand. Sorry, Marin. Nice casting handstand there from Michaela. Start the routine. Release a little bit of leg separation as she was coming down to the low bar on that overshoot there. Michaela's one of the taller gymnasts on the team, but makes her lines and the way she swings bars unique and much, it's very pretty to watch. Nice stick there for Michaela.
Really good exhibition routine, like we said, similar to the Fighting Illini. Good to see gymnasts even doing their exhibition, having such great performances. Always good to see if you're a coach to have that depth in your roster. Just one more gymnast to go on an exhibition for Michigan State, Jory Jackard.
Jory had a perfect 10-0 last season on the uneven bars.
Struggled a little bit on the uneven bars, only scoring a 9. Just an exhibition match. We'll be looking to get back into the swing of things.
Jory has beautiful execution on this event. She separates herself with her toe point and her long, clean lines. Handstand right on top of the bar, just like that. That's what she missed last weekend. Good to recover for her with the catch there. Very nice. And again, that toe point is exquisite. Beautiful handstand. She has a full pirouette into a double tuck, looking for the stick here. And she gets it. Two fantastic exhibition routines for Michigan State.
Yeah, really nice to see there from Jackard. Recovering after struggling a bit at Michigan.
This was a skill she missed. She had just got on her fingertips and couldn't hang on last weekend. So good to see her recover here.
So that will do it for the second rotation. Michigan State currently leading 98.55. Illinois just behind them with a 97.9. Both teams not scoring as high as they would have liked in that second rotation, but looking to bounce back in the third. Now we're going to get ready to send it down to Nora Fleming, standing by with Coach Mike Rowe.
Thanks, Marin. I'm here with Michigan State head coach Mike Rowe. Coach Rowe, you said that the momentum in the meet against Michigan was key to the win. How is that momentum carried over today?
I think we're doing the same thing right now. We started off a little slow on ball, but we saw some really good improvement. Obviously, we're trying to stick landings, and that's a big focus. When it doesn't always happen, your scores are a little low. So coming to bars and doing a little bit better, stuck a couple more. I think we're in a good spot right now, and I think we'll go to Beam and we'll do even more.
Absolutely. And what does the team need to do to secure a win?
Stay on their feet, first of all, and you know, just keep building like we've been doing. We're finishing on floor, fortunate to be home, and that's traditionally one of our stronger events. We're so really excited about that.
Thank you so much, and good luck with the rest of the meet.
Thanks so much.
Don't go anywhere. More women's gymnastics next on Big Ten Plus.
For Michigan State, coming off the high of beating Michigan, they had a lot to kind of live up to tonight. So hopefully they can bring it back, both teams, here on the last two events.
As we look back at some of those landings on the uneven bars for Michigan State, and now looking over to the vault, both teams just struggling with those landings, some hops back, steps back. So not scoring as high as they would like to be heading into this third rotation. Going to be looking for some high scores from both sides.
They are certainly capable of doing that.
So we look at the floor order For Illinois, we'll have Ward, Fitzgibbon, Morgan, Knight, Mueller, and Towns. We mentioned Mueller recently getting a new career high just a few weeks ago.
Should have looked to recreate that tonight.
Yeah, didn't score at high as Rutgers, had a 9.75. We'll really be looking to pull out a big score here in East Lansing. So we'll look at Michigan State's competition order. Khalifi, Tucker, Ortiz, Schulte, Garcia, and Steven. Michigan State will also have German and Buffet for exhibitions. And exhibitions for Illinois in this rotation will be Ewald and Burn on the floor.
Close up there, Schulte. You can see the bedazzles and things they have to match their Leos tonight.
Schulte and Khalifi getting a talk from coach and getting ready. Had a 9.925 on the beam at Michigan, tying her season high. Talented gymnast on the beam will be looking to have a big start on this rotation for Michigan State.
The leadoff position in every rotation is key, but especially on balance beam. You want to start with a gymnast that's confident and strong, solid in their performance here. Gianna's been a great leadoff performer for them a few seasons now. Start here with her series. She's a triple series, two back handsprings into a layout step out, solid. Into her leap pass here, switch leap, tuck jump full, slight adjustment there. Her shoulders keep herself in alignment on the beam. Good save, though. Jenna has nice movement and fluidity to her beam routine here. Gearing up for her dismount cartwheel into a gainer full stick for Gianna. Excellent leadoff routine for Michigan State.
What a great way to start for the Spartans from Khalifi.
That's that stick they've been looking for. Another look at her dismount here. Swing through full. Again, you can see that heels come together at the end. No deduction. And she gets the stick shield.
Now Caitlin Ewald starting on the floor. Looks like a last minute updated lineup for the Fighting Illini on their floor. So Ewald will start it off.
It's nice to see a gymnast begin the routine with a smile on their face. Starts with a front double full. A little bit of leg separation execution there. Kind of crossed in that double full. Gymnasts have the ability to pick and choose their music, as well as the choreography is tailored to each gymnast, fit their personalities here. Comes back with a front one and a half to a layout step out. Routines are required to have a two salto pass, which means they flip twice without their hands touching the floor. So that satisfied the requirement for her there. Pass, switch half, straddle full, straddle jump. Showing her flaw for flexibility in that leap rotation. Leap series, I mean. And nice routine, good start for the Illini.
Very nice routine from Ewald to start it off, and always fun to see the gymnast personalities coming out in those floor routines.
Absolutely.
And now Michaela Tucker on the beam for Michigan State, and Khalifi score coming in at 9.9, so a good way to start on the beam for the Spartans.
Kayla Trigger looking to build on that here. Front aerial, this is her series, directly into a back handspring. As long as she keeps the motion moving in her arms, she gets connection for that series. Again, with Michaela's height, she's beautiful to watch on the balance beam. Coming back here for her acro series. Cat leap into an aerial. Solid again. And the full turn is a requirement in every beam routine. It's the simplest skill that the gymnast will do, but sometimes can be the nemesis skill as well, where you seem to mess up on the simple things. And back handspring swing through to a gainer full. Fantastic stick for Michaela there. They're getting these landings figured out.
Definitely something the Spartans are liking to see here in this third rotation, getting those strong landings. As we'll head it, take another look.
This is her dismount again.
Strong dismount.
Back handspring into the gainer full. No movement of the feet.
Really strong dismount from the freshman. We head back over to the floor where Fitzgibbon is getting ready for her floor routine. Ewald, her score coming in at a 9.75.
There's dramatic music here. Teammates on the sidelines helping her dance. And she does a punch front layout to a Rudy. Again, that suffices for her two salto pass. And back with her leap pass here. Switch side, split full. On her second pass here. Double pike. Nice finish there with that controlled landing. And a nice routine there.
Yeah, both these teams doing a great job here in this third rotation to start out, especially on those landings. They were struggling in the second and really starting to figure it out, a nice landing there on that pass from Fitzgibbon. It's now Gabby Ortiz on the bars for Michigan State.
Gabby on the bounce, we can see those scores that have come in thus far for teammates prior. Nice start here on the balance beam. Like Gabby's little hair fluff there. She does a back handspring layout, step out, solid. Michigan State's attacking beam. Sometimes it's hard to do so and not be nervous as you're up there competing. But the girls are doing a great job of letting their training come through, showing confidence as they're up on the apparatus. Slight correction she had to make there. Turned her hips a little bit to keep herself upright. Into her dismount here, back handspring 1.5, just the smallest hop forward. Be a slight deduction for that, but good third routine for Michigan State.
Good routine there from the freshman. Also tied her season high at Michigan with a 9.9. So take another look at that landing. Just like you said, sir, the smallest step, so a deduction there, but otherwise a really solid routine from the freshman, as we'll head back over to the floor for Allie Morgan and her floor routine.
9.85 from Fitzgibbon. That was a nice score for them in that second routine. And a double tuck to open the routine here. Solid, again, controlled landing there. Nice chest positioning as she was finishing the skill. Again, gorgeous toe point here. That was her leap combination. Judges are looking for those combinations to have a full rotation all the way around. If your feet don't quite close out that full rotation, it can be a deduction or you may not get credit for the full skill. And a front layout punch, front full. Having a little bit of fun here. Gorgeous flexibility. And a nice routine. Illini are solid.
Illini looking very good on the floor, and Fitzgibbon had a 9.8 in the last meet.
Double tuck here. Again, that toe point she held all the way throughout the double tuck, which was nice to see. Skyla Schulte mounting now for Michigan State. Showing off her flexibility as well here. Required full turn.
Schulte had a season high at Michigan, a 9.95 on beam. We're looking to have another high scoring performance here for the Spartans as the third gymnast up, fourth.
Skyla starts with her lead pass. Switch leap, switch half. It's kind of her trademark move there, that straddle down to the balance beam. Again, you can see personality show through in some of the beam dance as well. Skyla gears up for her back handspring layout. Solid finish with that. She did make a slight adjustment. It's a seasoned professional there to adjust her shoulder positioning just a bit to keep herself in the proper alignment. Switch leap into her gainer full. Ever so slight hop backwards on that dismount.
Dismount.
Actually, her series first. This is the dismount here. And a small hop backwards.
Now Aaliyah Byrne on the floor for the Fighting Illini. Byrne was scheduled for an exhibition, but moved up as the alternate.
It's nice to have those gymnasts that you know you can rely upon. They warm everything up in exhibition, and if you need to call them at the last minute, they are ready to go. Nice opening pass for her there. It's a 2.5 to a punch front pike. Her lead pass, having some fun with her teammates on the sidelines. Big smile for the judges. Just come in for her second pass here. Back by handspring double pike. A little short in that landing, didn't quite have enough rotation to finish it fully. Had to take a step forward to keep herself upright. Tough skill to finish on, though, but she did a great job keeping herself up and not having a deduction for a fall with that.
Let's look at another look at that pass from Byrne.
Didn't quite get the rotation that she needed to finish pulling all the way through. Had to take the step forward again. Could be a sizable deduction for that, unfortunately, for the Illini.
And now Bailey Garcia up on the beam as we see those scores from Michigan State already looking solid. The 9.9, a pair of 9.87s and a 9.925, 9.825, excuse me.
is a very graceful beam worker. Beautiful finish on that back handspring layout for her. She moves so fluidly through the routine. And a front aerial. Again, a slight adjustment. Judges can take a deduction there for the shoulder drop to her right there between the two elements. Great job for her on that leap series. Switch leap to a split jump. Gymnasts have to build their routine for start value. They have to do connection bonus and got the stick. Connection bonus and high difficulty elements in order to start from their 10-0.
Another beautiful stick there on the beam for Michigan State, really finding those landings.
And this again is a replay of that dismount. Got the stick. Chest is a slight bit down as she's trying to salute. Those feet did not move, though.
Now Aaliyah Byrne on the floor. See those scores, that last score from Morgan. Not as high as the Illini would like.
Just ran out of a little bit of gas on that double pike. Hopefully they can come back here and be able to drop that 9.65 score with the last couple of gymnasts here. Does a front through to a double tuck, and much better landing there. She landed with her chest fully vertical, which is what the judges would like to see. A little bit of a Western flair here to this routine. Dancing into the corner, she prepares for her next tumbling pass. This will be her two salto pass, a front layout, through to a front fold. Good controlled landing again there. Switch leap, split fold, split jump. She has such a good time out there on the floor, you can tell. A big smile the whole way through for her.
Really nice routine there coming from Mueller. Getting another look at those passes.
Opening pass. That chest position, you can see she was all the way vertical. That was a beautiful pass for her to open with.
A really good, solid routine there for the Illini. Now over to Gabby Steven, the final Spartan on the beam before the two exhibitions.
He has a fun mount there. Confidence Michigan State is as they move through this lineup. Gabby has unique skill here. It's a front toss. She does it in a laid out position, though. Most gymnasts that do that skill do it in a tuck position. It's pretty impressive to have that much rotation to be able to hit your body fully laid out the whole way through. Perfect job on that full turn from Gabby. Taking a breath here before her series. Back handspring layout, solid from Gabby. She had a couple of slight bubbles last weekend on her routine. We actually ended up being the score that they dropped, Michigan State dropped, was Gabby's. Good series there from her flutter jump to a straddle half. And she's geared up for her dismount. Beautiful job by Gabby. Got the stick. And that 1 second pause, that was a perfect example. Great anchor spot from Gabby from Michigan State Gymnastics.
Really solid way to finish off the scoring portion of the beam in that third rotation for Michigan State.
That was that front toss I was speaking about. And her dismount. Legs glued together, finds the ground, holds for the second before the salute.
Absolutely beautiful form on that dismount. Stuck the landing. Michigan State really finding those landings. Here in the third rotation is now the final gymnast on the floor, Mia Towns.
The judges are speaking with one another at the moment. That can happen sometimes if there is a start value discrepancy where one judge might have the gymnast starting at a 10-0 and that someone else might have them starting at only a 9-9. So they must conference to figure out what the discrepancy was between one another.
Some discussions waiting for those scores, getting a look at Towns. Towns won the floor against Rutgers, had a 9-9 for the Fighting Illini. We'll be looking to finish it out in this third rotation with a strong routine.
Makes it a little bit tough when there's a judges conference and you're the next gymnast to go. Just have to keep a clear mind and take a deep breath here.
Is Mueller's score coming in at a 9.775. As we'll see those scores from all the Illini on the floor.
Yeah, again, ready to party out there. Having a good time with her teammates on the sidelines. Showing off that personality. She does a front 1.5. Beautiful straddle jump. Nice height on that. That mat that you see down being pulled out of the way, that is okay to use. It's just extra cushion for the gymnast when they land their skill. Michael Jackson. 1.5 to a punch front full.
Towns having a lot of fun in this routine and sticking those landings so far. Really strong performance.
I'm smiling up here. I hope the judges are smiling watching her dance this routine. She's had nice execution all the way through this as well. Wolf jump 1.5. Leap pass, switch leap full to a split full. Nice routine there for their anchor. Great job.
Really strong way to finish it out for Illinois. In that third rotation, getting a look at that pass.
Again, front 1.5 to a beautiful straddle jump here. Look at the height she gets out of that connection.
Now Naomi German with her exhibition on the beam for Michigan State. German and Buffet will be doing exhibitions for Michigan State.
Unique chest cartwheel there that she did on the balance beam to open. And full turn. Again, using these exhibition spots here to gain confidence. See how each gymnast would score in front of the judges. Triple series here for Naomi. If I can't handspring layout step out. You see a little bit of nerves in her. She's just not quite confident in herself up there yet. Perfect reason to do this exhibition routine and get some of these nerves out of the way. She's doing a great job just continuing to move throughout the routine here, though. Leap pass for her. Switch leap. Sheep jump. Oh, goodness. So she stayed on the balance beam. That technically will be an on-the-beam fall, however. She actually was off on the switch leap to the left side of the beam. I'm a little bit shocked that she still went for the sheep jump. And swing full for her dismount. Beautiful stick for that landing.
A good stick and way to keep her composure after that fall. Good job to stay on the beam, not go down, and finish out her routine.
Yes, good composure from her for sure. That did not feel good.
No, definitely
so
not.
Her feet were off to the side here. She's coming to the left side, her shoulder drop. So she just missed that foot to the opposing side and coupled with her thigh, of course. But again, great job to be able to stay up there and continue the routine throughout. One more routine to go here for Michigan State. Eli and I have wrapped up their floor rotation.
Buffet for Michigan State. Finishing this off with an exhibition on the beam before we head into the fourth and final rotation. We saw the score coming in for Mia Towns on the floor, 9.925 once again.
Well deserved.
Leading her team in that event, really good performance.
So only a 9.15 from one of the judges, 8.9 from the other. So they did give her an on-the-beam fall, and she lost some start value because she did not finish that leap series. But again, good to get some of those nerves out of the way in an exhibition environment.
Spoufey starting her exhibition on the beam.
She's been a floor competitor for the Spartans, looking to add the beam into her mix as well. Beautiful height on that layout from her triple series. She rose coming out of the back handspring. She has nice movement on the balance beam as well. Pretty dance as she's moving down the apparatus. Switch leap. Straddle quarter. Good slight adjustment there. Beautiful execution there on that late pass. Just talking to herself a little bit as she's wrapping up the routine here. Giving her verbal cues. Little things to think about as she finishes the routine. And it's a round off 1.5. Had a slight hop. Nice chest positioning at the end of that though. Good exhibition for Ellie.
Yeah, really nice exhibition, especially like you said, Sarah. Normally you're seeing her on floor starting to move over the beam a little bit, so a really strong exhibition.
It's nice to see some of the gymnasts be able to add to the repertoire as the season goes.
Yeah, something Coach Mike Rose really wanted to work on with his gymnasts, adding skills, adding some new skills for all of them and some more intense skills. You see hugs for Buffet and Michigan State leading 147.95. Iowa just behind them, 147.025. So Michigan State starting to pull ahead. Some really strong performances there on the beam. Illinois, some strong performances, especially from Towns, but a little bit of catching up to do here on the beam.
Michigan State beam total will be their highest event total thus far in the meet tonight. So they're doing what they were hoping for. Keep building upon those first two rotations. Down some more of those landings on balance beam. Looking to keep it moving forward on floor.
So heading into the fourth rotation, Michigan State on floor. Illinois on the beam. We're going to send it down to Nora and Lexi standing by with another woman in sports, Aaliyah Moore from Michigan State Volleyball. Keep talking.
Volleyball player, but we saw you playing a little bit of field hockey earlier today. How'd that go?
You know, I'm not used to playing with a stick or a ball this small, but they taught us a lot, and I think I could sub in.
Well, thanks so much for chatting with us. We won't keep you too long, but don't go anywhere quite yet. We have more gymnastics coming up here on Big Ten Plus.
Michigan State leading 147.95 to 147.025 as we get a look here at our control room in honor of National Women and Girls in Sports today. This is an all-female broadcast. Every single member of our crew today is a female, honoring all the girls working in sports here at Michigan State. Me, Sarah Sageman, joining us here on our crew today. Our sideline reporters, Lexi Alston, Nora Fleming, as well as our amazing director, Alexa Wolquist, producer Alexa Wolquist, and director Victoria Irish. A lot of amazing women here on this crew today to join these teams in celebrating National Women and Girls in Sports Day. Both these teams getting ready for their fourth and final rotation. Michigan State on the floor and Illinois on the beam. as we'll take a look at the performances from the third rotation.
Gianna in that series again. Nice high double tuck. It's open for the Illini. Opening tumbling pass. And it dismounts solid stick on that landing.
So we're getting a look at the competition order for Illinois on the beam. Towns, Knight, Ewald, Mueller, Nataraj, and Takakawa in the anchor spot on the beam. Now looking over at the floor for Michigan State, Buffet, Tucker, Stephen, Harkness, Smith, and Schulte. And last time that Michigan State was back here in Jennison Fieldhouse, Nikki Smith, the first Spartan to get a perfect 10 on the floor. A huge moment for the program.
Interesting, former Spartan herself, assistant coach Nicole Furler-Jones, down there discussing with her girls.
As Towns is getting ready on the beam, had a 9.8 at Rutgers, a season high of 9.825.
He is the anchor on four, and yet the leadoff on balance beam. It's impressive to be able to play both roles here for the Illini.
Definitely a quick turnaround. She gets a pep talk from coach, some fist bumps, and is getting ready to go. Michigan State getting ready for their cheer for this fourth rotation.
Requirement in the beam routine that you must be down on the beam at some point during the routine. Switch leap to a straddle quarter. Good solid finish for her there. Again, showing that confidence there, making eye contact with the judges as she's working through her dance elements. Cat leap into an aerial. Nice finish. Unit for her series. That cane spring back layout. Slight shuffle of the foot. Oh, and she couldn't quite hold on. Kind of double bounced her back foot there at the end of the layout. Caused her to have to take an extra step forward and then just knocked herself off balance a bit. Tough when your leadoff has a fall. It puts a little extra pressure on the remainder of the lineup coming forward. She's doing a nice job finishing confidently here. I love this dance she has on balance beam, showing her personality. It's nice to see some creativity in the dance elements as well. Finishing up with her dismount here. Round off 1.5. In a slight tuck position. Had to lift that leg at the end. Again, hopefully this is with a routine that the Illini will drop for their rotation here. They can have 5 hits after this.
Good way to finish out after that fall off the beam.
Just a little bit off to the side on that round off.
Just a bit to the side, and not exactly the way the Illini were looking to start on the beam. Is now ahead to Buffet on the floor, and like you mentioned, Sarah, seeing a lot of personalities in both beam and floor in these rotations with the dance elements.
Yes, nice front double full for Ellie there. She actually uses the mat to begin her punch versus the landing. She has some of the same dance elements in her beam routine that she has in her floor routine here. Nice amplitude on her leap pass. Judges are looking for a full 180 split. which really means that the gymnast must go beyond the 180 in order for the eye to catch it, being a full split, actually. Coming back here, around a 1.5 front layout for Ellie. Good control on that landing. Gymnasts are allowed a step on floor exercise, unlike the other events. So they can land their tumbling pass and take a controlled step forward on a front pass or backwards on a back tumbling pass without any execution deductions. They're looking to finish their third pass here. Punch 1.5. Beautiful landing. Nice stretch on the salute there. Great start for Michigan State.
Buffet always with a really strong routine to start out for the Spartans. Once again, beautiful routine, beautiful execution from Ellie.
That was her 2 salto pass and her last one to finish the routine.
Now Knight on the beam.
Unique Towns amount here.
Towns came in with a 9.125. Hopefully be the score. The Illini will be looking to drop. Knight struggled a bit against Rutgers, had a 9.2 on the beam. Will be looking to bounce back.
And again, some of that added pressure after having a fall in the leadoff. They just have to rely upon their training here and do the gymnastics they know they're capable of. Nice leap pass, which leap into a split leap and then beat jump. Illinois is known for their pretty dance on balance beam. Side aerial into a back handspring. Good correction. Had her hips entirely sideways on the balance beam, so she did well to control that back and correct herself. That was her echo series there. And now a side summy. Just to gain extra bonus in the routine. A little bit, see some of those nerves creeping in, but she's done well to control them. Still stay up on top of the beam here. And into her dismount. Gainer full, small little step on the dismount, but a nice way to come back from a fall in the first routine. She has stuck her team for that second position.
Take a look here at that dismount. Small step, but a good way to come back, like you said. After that fall, and now Michaela Tucker on the floor from Michigan State had her season high of 9.9 on floor against Michigan.
Michaela opens with a front double full. I'm sorry, 1.5 back layout. The double full comes later in the routine.
The face score came in at a 9.875.
So again here, Michaela opened with her 2 salto pass versus her increased difficulty pass. Again, dancing it up for her teammate there. Gabby Ortiz in her corner, cheering her on.
The 2 gymnasts on this team both won Big Ten Freshman of the Week honors, both Ortiz and Tucker. Having a great first year with the Spartans.
And coming back for the front double full to finish the routine here. Great execution with that. Nice controlled landing as well. Great shot from the camera there. Okay, looking right into the camera to finish the routine. Nice second routine for the Spartans.
Very strong. You see teammates coming to congratulate her.
This is her opening pass here. Front 1.5. Layout step out. Good combo. Got her feet in from the out of bounds markers there. And a 9.7 in the second spot for Illinois. So back on track.
Now Ewald up for her beam routine.
She begins with a one-arm backhand spring. So that first element, she only put one hand down to the balance beam. Switch leap into a standing layout step out. Beautiful series there. She's looking very solid. Nice confidence here in the third spot for Illinois. Split jump, straddle quarter. Unique combination here. This is a fun routine. See some different elements than we're used to seeing from the other routines. Looking for the dismount here. Add a Rudy off the end. And a stick for the Illini. Great routine in that third spot. That's what they were looking for. Excellent job.
That is the routine the Fighting Illini needed.
Look at the leap series here. Split jump, straddle quarter.
Really good height on those beautiful landings and stuck that landing on the dismount. So we'll head back over to the floor and Gabby Steven up for Michigan State.
Michigan State solid so far. Looking to continue building on these scores here. Gabby does a front through to a double pike. Nice control in that landing there. Chest was a little bit forward as she landed, but was able to move right into the lunge position.
Michigan State with a lot of power routines here on the floor. A new choreographer for the team this year. You can really see the personality of these girls coming out in each routine.
Yes, Gabby has lots of power. She mixes it with grace as well, though, which is a nice combination in her gymnastics.
And Tucker's score came in at 9.9, so tying that season high that she achieved just last week.
And Gabby looking to finish out tumbling passes here. There's a front double full. Nice control. Finishing with her E-level element there. And nice routine.
Spartan staying strong in this fourth rotation, getting a look at that pass from Steven.
Nice front double full.
And now Mueller on the beam. See that score for Ewald coming in at 9.850. So after a rocky start on the beam, the Fighting Illini building themselves back up.
You were looking to keep it going here. Moving into her series. Backhand spring layout step out. Slight adjustment she had to make, but that was great to finish solid. Afterward. Switch leap, straddle quarter. Not quite as much amplitude as we have seen in some of the leaps, but nice solid finish for her. Combination acro series there. Dance helmet into the front toss. She's gearing up for her dismount. Round off 1.5. Gets the stick. Good veteran move there. She was a little bit in her heels as she was finishing the skill, but able to adjust her body positioning to not have to take that step backwards. Great finish.
Yeah, really
see this
nice
dismount again.
Really
a little
nice
bit
finish.
Back as she opens. There she is, but able to squeeze and still get that stick.
Fighting Illini really building up after that first routine. See Steven score also coming in at 9.9, and now Delaney Harkness. Towns is still holding the top score on the floor with a 9.925.
Delaney open in here. She does a round of a handspring full in. Beautiful beautiful positioning on the landing for her. Nice controlled lunge out of that. Showing a little bit of personality and sass there with her teammates. Like to see the gymnasts having a good time in their floor routines. Sometimes they get so focused on what they're doing and getting the elements all exactly right, you forget to just let it loose and have a good time.
And not only the gymnasts on the floor, but their teammates beside them, knowing all these dance moves, doing it right along with them.
Delaney's working through all of her dance elements here. Music slows just a bit, getting preparation for her last pass. With a front through to a double tuck. Almost a stick. She opened just a little bit early, so she tried to stick it instead of taking that lunge backwards. We'll see what the judges do with that landing, if they take deductions or if they give her the stick for it. My guess is they probably take something for her on that lack of control on the landing. So front through here, she just opened a little bit early on the rotation and ended with shoulders in front of herself.
On the beam, Ratu Nadrara. She struggled a little bit in her last time on beam at Ohio State, a 9.050, but a season high of 9.85, so
looking
can
solid
be strong.
On her series so far.
We're really looking to build on what the Illini have done so far on the beam.
Sleep straddle quarter. Again, showing some of this nice dance Illinois is known for. Beautiful hands working throughout this routine. Combination elements there into the front aerial. Good control on that landing. Looking confident throughout this routine. Checked off the full turn here and backing up for her dismount. Fun little dance she had for the ending here. Round off 1.5 and gets the stick. Eli and I are continuing to build.
Mataraj really picking it up on the beam. Last time out, she struggled, went down. And now Nikki Smith. So we'll get a look here at that perfect 10 on the floor that she had just 2 weeks ago.
She stuck her opening tumbling pass and came back with a nice controlled landing on that last one as well. She actually has 3 tumbling passes.
This Harkness' score came in at 9.9, so 3 9.9s in a row for the Spartans.
Beautiful. She actually does not grab her legs in her full end. She does an open position is what it's called, which is more difficult because you don't use your arms to help increase your rotation. Nice leap pass for her there. Coming back for pass 2. One and a half front layout. Again, good control. It's just time for some fun. See her teammates cheering her on in her corner. Down to her last pass here. Ground flick handspring double tuck. Nice, beautiful height and a stick again on that last pass. We shall see what the judges do with that. That should be a good score. I'm not sure if she'll get her 10 again today, but that should be an excellent score for the Spartans.
Nikki Smith continues to impress on the floor for Michigan State at home. Beautiful passes, beautiful landings. Like you said, might not be that perfect 10, but looking to score high, and the Spartans still looking to pass Towns, holding the lead in floor with a 9.925. As Nataraj's score comes in at a 9.85. And now Takakawa at the anchor position for Illinois.
She does it. Side aerial, back handspring beautifully done there. Nice extension throughout that series. Solid landing. Full turn, she kicks out of her full turn. Showed a nice stretched straight leg afterward. Her leap pass. She switched leap into a gainer layout step out. Some fun dance elements here just to add some creativity to the routines. Judges appreciate having a little bit of variance amongst the routines. Gearing up for her dismount, a back handspring swing through, and a stuck landing. What a way to finish there for the Illini. Beautiful routine.
A beautiful anchor position. Mia Takakawa finishing it up. So you see the 10 chance coming from the teammates. After a really rocky start in this fourth rotation on the beam, the Fighting Illini bounce back in a beautiful routine from Takakawa. We're heading back over to the floor now for Skyla Schulte, currently leading the all-around competition.
9.95 from Smith on that last routine. Skyla's seeing if she can match or top it. Full in from her, beautifully controlled there. Skyler probably has the most personality out of all of her teammates when she's competing. See everybody behind her dancing along with her. Skyler also has beautiful flexibility here, which she shows off in her leap passes. Pulled that shuttle all the way around to get full credit for the dance elements. She's going to finish here with her two-pass routine. She just comes back with the front through. Runs by handspring double pike. Look for the landing. A little bit extra power. She had a slight bounce back on that last pass there. So nice control in the first pass. Not quite the same control in that last one, but a great way to finish for the Spartans.
Let's take a look at the passes from Schulte.
It's her opening full in. Beautiful control with that one.
Takakawa score coming in at a 9.95. That will be a new season high for Mia. Not the perfect 10 that the team was looking for, but given where the team started on the beam, a really good way to come back as we'll head now into the exhibitions.
Yes, well-deserved score there for Mia. That was a beautiful routine.
Emma White now on the beam for her exhibition.
Emma getting another taller gymnast, similar to Michaela Tucker for Michigan State. She has beautiful extension throughout her dance here. Back handspring layout step out. Oh, opened her hips a little bit, just couldn't quite get her balance back in check and close the hip to be able to stay on the balance beam. And cat leap into a front aerial. She fought for that one. Way to get a foot down to finish the skill. A little moonwalking on the beam. Mm-hmm. actually straddle quarter. Some relief pass that we've seen from others tonight. Oh, and there's the full turn. The nemesis skill, that simplest one, but sometimes can cause you the most trouble. Finishing with her dismount here. Gain her full. And again, nice to get that routine under her belt. Maybe not exactly the routine she was hoping to put on show for tonight, but get some scores in, get some nerves out of the way, and be able to build on that.
Sometimes nice in those exhibition matches just to kind of get some nerves out of the way, get practice in a meet, but know the score. Be counted as now Nia Smith up for her exhibition on the floor. Schulte score claim in at a 9.875.
Great rotation for Michigan State. And Nia opening up here with a full in. I'm not sure if she stepped out of bounds or not. It was very close. She was definitely on the line. I don't think I saw a judge raise their flag, which means they won't deduct for that. Nia's adding a full in to her difficulty this year. She did not compete a full in last year. Pretty impressive as a fifth year to be still adding new skills. And her leap pass here. Switch leap, switch side straddle full. Again, showing some of this personality and flair here. Just having a good time. And a future Spartan gymnast back there dancing with her. Front through to double tuck for Nia. Beautifully executed double tuck there. Chest high on the landing, controlled step backwards, and finishes with her crown.
Very nice routine, always good to see throughout this whole meet. Spartan exhibitions have been just as strong as the gymnast competing.
You're exactly right. Again, showing some of that depth, where if they need to rest somebody or if they can have the luxury of that. It hasn't always been the case where you can have enough gymnasts to be able to take a break for some of them.
Now, the final exhibition for the Illini, Ariel Ward on the beam.
She's mounting in preparation for a wolf turn here. This is a skill that's become very popular in international gymnastics, elite level gymnastics. It's a lot of bonus. It's a much harder skill than it appears. She actually did a double turn there. And a back handspring, layout step out. Oh, fight. Good try. Just some nerves here for these exhibition routines. These girls certainly are capable of nailing these series and things. Again, just time to get in front of the judges, be able to be in front of a crowd, pressure set to get some experience under your belt. And switch leap jump into a straddle quarter for her leap series elements. And her dismount, gainer full off the side, small step backwards. Nice routine, gain some confidence with that. That'll be a pretty routine to be able to add to a lineup if needed.
Yeah, especially on the confidence. Coaches now in college gymnastics really trying to push gymnasts to trying new things, getting on skills they may not always be used to doing, and those exhibitions help shake away some of the nerves. As Gianna Khalifi, the final exhibition on the floor for Michigan State. Michigan State took away that lead on the floor. Nikki Smith with a 9.950, but Mia Takakawa for Illinois took the lead in the beam with her 9.95. So the Illini staying on that leaderboard.
And Gianna coming here for her first opening pass, a front double full. Beautifully done. And she comes right back to tumble again to the same corner here. And punch one and a half, layout step out. Again, nice control on the landing there. Switch leap, and she brings it around for a full stretch, switch side to a Shushanova. Getting some creativity in those leap passes that they've chosen for Gianna. And beautiful finish there.
Finish there, and a great way to finish out the meet for the Spartans with those two exhibitions on the floor, and that will do it here at Jenison for both these teams. Michigan State taking the victory at home, 197.475 to 196.175. Both these teams started out a little rocky on those first two rotations, not exactly getting the landings they wanted. Both really cleaned it up there in the final two rotations, but Michigan State stayed on top. Some really dominant performance, like we said, not only in their competitors, but great to see from their exhibitions too, a lot of depth in this team.
Yes, absolutely. Good to see the Spartans have some extra players in their back pocket for sure. Again, they can add in if needed, or even just a rest gymnast.
So Michigan State, Sage Kellerman taking the win on vault, Harkness on the bars, Takakawa for Illinois on the beam, Smith on floor, and Skyla Schulte with the all-around score of 39.475, a great performance from the all-around gymnast today to take that title for this meet. The ranked Spartans continuing to stay undefeated in conference. Want to see if your coach Mike Rowe. Michigan State will be hosting the Big Ten Championship, and the longer you stay undefeated, the more energy and power you're going to have going into
Absolutely.
That championship.
Newer to gymnastics as well, there is the regular season Big Ten Champion. It used to only be Big Ten Champion for a tournament style. There was one meet that would declare the champion. So last year, Michigan State was able to claim that regular season Big Ten Champ status.
Skyla Schulte winning that all-around impressive performance from Schulte and all of Michigan State here to take this win on women and girls in sports night.
Yes, solid performance from Michigan State. Not quite the 198 they had last week, but like we said in the beginning, they had a little bit of struggles on finding landings. They were able to improve upon that as the meet continued and got a solid 197.475. That's still a great finish for the Spartans. Alumni of 196.175. They can clean up some of their, again, landings and things from the start of their meet. Unfortunately, had just a few little wobbles after the initial fall on balance beam. Just added that extra pressure for the subsequent gymnasts from there.
Strong performances from both teams. Illinois, while falling, going down more. In conference play, still some good performances, especially on their floor routines, really strong from the Fighting Illini.
Absolutely.
But Michigan State remaining on top and, like we said, remaining undefeated in Big Ten play. Really impressive from Michigan State, the Big Ten regular season champions. And we're going to get ready to send it down to Nora and Lexi standing aside on the floor with some of the champions from Michigan State today.
I'm here with reigning Big Ten Freshman of the Week, Michaela Tucker. Michaela, after scoring career highs on all three of your events against Michigan, what was your focus coming into this meet?
Just doing the same thing. I came in, I didn't do as well, but pretty well.
And what energy are you trying to channel in your floor routine this year?
Say that again, sorry.
What energy are you trying to channel in your floor routine?
Based on my score today and last week, my teammates by the side just cheering me on. It's super high energy, so.
Absolutely. And in honor of National Women and Girls in Sports Day, what does being a woman in sports mean to you?
I don't know. Everything. I don't know. I just love it, and yeah.
Absolutely. Well, congratulations and good luck on the rest of your season.
Thank you.
Thank you. And from all of us at Big Ten Plus, thank you for watching.
I'm here with the one and only Sage Kellerman. Now, Sage, you are now the only Spartan to earn multiple perfect scores in the same event. You know, just tell me a little bit about that and what it means to make program history.
I'm so thankful for everyone who was there, and that encouraged me, especially for Devin, my coach.
And obviously you're an incredible athlete, but today as a whole is all about women in sports. What is that role to you?
I think it's so incredible that so many young gymnasts look up to me, and it's so fun to mentor them as well.
And obviously now you're undefeated in the Big Ten. How do you plan to keep those momentum going forward?
I plan to just continue working hard in the gym every day and letting my teammates encourage me as well as Devin.
Thank you so much, Sage, and again, great job today. I won't keep you too long. From all of us here at Big Ten Plus, thanks for watching.
To Jenison Fieldhouse, we're going to send it down to the award ceremony here in East Lansing.
In second place with a score of 9.9 from Michigan State University, Nikki Smith. Your vault champion this evening with a score of 9.925 from Michigan State University, Sage Kellerman. Congratulations to our vault champions tonight, ladies. Please salute. On the bars of 285 for second place with a 9.875 from Illinois, Lyden Sultanus. Also with a 9.875 from Illinois, Mia Pekakawa. Our bar champion this evening with a score of 9.925 from Michigan State University, Delaney Harkness. Congratulations to our bar champions this evening. Ladies, please salute. On the beam in third place, with a score of 9.9 from Michigan State University, Gianna Khalifi. In second place, with a 9.925 from Michigan State University, Gabby Steven. Our beam champion this evening with a 9.950 from Illinois, Mia Takakawa. Congratulations to our beam champions this evening. Ladies, please salute. On the floor, a three-way tie for third place with a 9.9 from Michigan State University, Delaney Harkness. Also with a 9.9 from Michigan State University, Gabby Steven. And with a 9.9 in third place from Michigan State University, Michaela Tucker. In second place with a 9.925 from the University of Illinois, Mia Towns. Our floor champion this evening with a 9.950 from Michigan State University, Nikki Smith. Congratulations to our floor champions this evening. Ladies, please salute. In the all-around competition, in third place with a 39.150 from the University of Illinois, Abby Miller. In second place with a 39.425 from Michigan State University, Gabby Steven. our all-around champion this evening with a 39.475 from Michigan State University, Skylar Shelty. Congratulations to our all-around champions this evening. Ladies, please salute. And in second place, we're 196.175, the University of Illinois. And the winner of tonight's meet, 197.475, Michigan State University.
So Michigan State at number 10 gets the win against Illinois, 197.475 to 196.175. Thank you so much, everyone, for tuning in here on this all-female broadcast on Big Ten Plus. For myself, Sarah Sageman alongside me, Nora Fleming, Lexi Alston, our director, Victoria Iris, and producer Alexa Wolkowitz, thank you so much for watching. Michigan State stays undefeated in conference with a big win tonight at home. You've been watching women's gymnastics on Big Ten Plus. Thanks, Lake.
Fans, for your safety and the safety of others around you, please stay off of the gymnastics equipment. Spartan F.